Sir, I beg to move that the bill further to amend the Constitution of India as passed by the Lok Sabha be taken into consideration. Sir, I am very happy to say that so far as this item of the business is concerned, it is free from any acrimony of any kind. Sir, the contents of this bill have received universal support throughout the country and in the other house, as is known to all section of this house. Sir, I will very briefly indicate, although it is hardly necessary to do so, as to what this bill is about. Sir, first of all, as is known to all the honorable members of this house, a provision had been introduced in the Constitution in the shape of Article 31D by the 42nd Amendment Act, by which a power had been given for banning the so-called anti-national activities and anti-national organizations or associations. Parliament had been given the power by that provision, which had been introduced in the Constitution, to make any law and to impose any kind of restriction on the people of this country which could transgress the fundamental rights guaranteed by the Constitution and contained in Articles 14, 19 and 31 of the Constitution. Sir, this was such a blanket power that the inclusion of Article 31D had come in for universal condemnation and criticism throughout the country. I am very happy to say that this is an attempt to redeem the pledge which had been given by the Janata Party to the people of this country. Of course, the pledge goes into various other matters also, which are still at the stage of discussion with the leaders of various political parties in the two houses. But so far as this is concerned, this particular proposal to repeal Article 31D and to delete it from the Constitution was universally and unanimously accepted. It was released that it was not necessary to give such drastic and draconian powers at the cost of the fundamental rights, at the cost of fundamental enshrined in Article 19, and even at the cost of the fundamental right to equality guaranteed by Article 14 in the name of anti-national activities and anti-national associations. I am thankful to all the honorable members for their unanimous support to the proposition which is being made by this bill.